morning, party people. If you can't tell, yes, I'm bougie now. I got me some fake AirPods. You can't get these nowhere. You probably can't afford them. You can find these at Walmart. You know what's good. We got that black. We got that rose gold. This is low-key promo. No, it's not. Anyway, I am on my way to the Servanthood Seminar because I was a lazy bum and didn't do it a long time ago. Don't judge me. We've discussed this. We don't do that here. We don't do that. But anyway, I'm on my way to class, and then I'll have another class after that, and then chapel, and let me stop boring y'all to death. Welcome back to another glorious week on this vlog. Hope you guys are enjoying everything so far. And I know I was supposed to do testimonies last week. I lied to y'all again, and I apologize. I'm trying. See, the way my brain is set up, maybe I should just, you know, yeah, y'all right. You right. I ain't got no excuse. I'm just being lazy. But anyway, let's go check this class out. All righty, party people. We are out on the field. It's time for a lovely game of football. I'm not all that great at it, but hey, I'm still playing anyway. Why don't we check it out? Welcome back, party people. Our team just finished playing. Yeah, everybody else did great. I'm dying. And then there's Isaiah.
Hi.
So right now the other teams are on the field. I'm trying to catch my breath. I ain't got the lungs for this, or the time. Apparently not the patience or the athletic ability. But hey, it's fine. We're here for the fellowships and the hangs. I'm gonna let y'all watch the other people play while I catch my breath. Y'all take it easy. Welcome back, party people. The game is over. Obviously, we won. Duh. Twice.
What?
What? I'm just kidding. Oh. You trying to say?
Sorry, we don't do gang signs here. We don't do gang signs here. That's why y'all didn't get to see me yet, because we don't do all that. Anyway, I will see you guys back at campus. You guys take it easy.
Well, good morning, party people. As you already know, it is a beautiful Sunday. I'm in the car with the peeps. We are on our way to Reliance. Oh, guys, look. I attempted a hipster look on my son. Let me know what you think. Leave a comment down in the comment section. Let him know that he looks good. I'm enjoying this light right now. Hold up. Anyway, we're on our way to Reliance. Hey, Ian. So how'd it go last night? Let's see you guys in the chair. How's it going, party people? We have successfully made it to church. Alrighty, guys. I'll catch you guys in just a second. I might let you hear the message if I feel like it. Alright, we'll catch you guys in a second. Well, good morning, party people. It is another glorious day on this vlog. It is a Monday morning, as you know. No class till 2, but homework. So, yeah. But you know what? I've realized I've never given you guys a full tour of the campus. I've just been going and naming all these random places and nobody knows what they are. So you know what I'm going to do? This week, I'm going to be showing you guys all around the campus. And I actually will let somebody do their testimony on Tuesday. It's going to be pretty awesome. I can't wait for you guys to see it. But for now, we're focused on today. Today's Monday. Why don't we go look at some things? So what's up, party people? Right now I'm in the library working on some homework, and my roommate Jake is working on his phys ed homework. I'm trying to get this out, but I can't stop laughing. So within the book, one of our dear brethren felt the need to protect us all. Shout out to this young man. Welcome back, party people. And so now we're at the end of our acts class, and I got our teachers to the side. This is Jeff and John Wang. So today they're gonna cover exactly what we covered in class today. So as you guys know, the 1 minute nugget, and it starts now. Jeff.
Me.
Yeah.
1 minute nugget. Stephen is the man. Stephen was full of faith, he was full of wisdom, he's filled with the Holy Spirit, and he's full of grace and power. And that's all because he just gave himself first to serving the Lord, and then the Lord raised him up and sent him out, and we see next week that he will be actually giving the sermon of all sermons to the Sanhedrin. And so thank you so much for being here today, and God bless you guys.
Amen. So John, take it away.
All right, from Acts chapter 5, in verse 20, when the apostles were in prison and God sent the angel to release them. Remember, the angel said, go into the temple and speak about this life. Hey, I just want to encourage you to remember that Christianity is all about the resurrection life of Jesus. It's about new life in Jesus, and we get to tell people about eternal life with Jesus. Everything about the Christian life is life. And so I want to encourage you to just, if you're not a Christian, to investigate the life of Christ. If you are a Christian, day by day, live in the reality of his resurrection life.
Fantastic. Aren't they great, you guys? Aren't they great?
I will see y'all next week.
God bless you, buddy.
So that was a covering of Acts chapter 6 and 5. We went in reverse order, so don't, we do what we want. Don't judge us. I'm just kidding. That's a joke. So I want you guys to keep steady. I'm going to go have some lunch, and then I'll see you guys later as Pete and hopefully Brian Higgins gives their testimony today. You guys take it easy. Hey, what's up, you guys? We are back. I just finished my homework somewhat last minute, but not. There's still 2 hours before class, so again, don't judge me. I did good this time. I actually did it. But guess who's with us? So Pete's going to give us his testimony today. I hope you guys are ready.
Hi everybody, I am Pete Perez, so I guess I'll be sharing my testimony today. You guys are in for a treat. It's kind of big and long, so get your popcorn ready. So I have to kind of start from the beginning. So my biological mother is from Ireland. She was a prostitute and came here to the Americas. She did a lot of drugs, alcohol, because of the fact she was a prostitute, that's where I came from. My biological father is from Cuba, moved to the United States, as far as I know, about their lives and stuff like that. I was born June 25th, 2000, instantly taken away because of the fact I was born with two drugs specifically in my system, methamphetamine and oxycodone, and taken directly into the foster system. Because of that, I moved around just a little bit. I wasn't in the foster system for too long, which I can say is kind of very much so a blessing. My biological mother knew my adopted parents, the people that have raised me. So she told the people through the foster system that she wants them to adopt me. So they did, about a year later after I was born. So raised in a Christian household, my dad became a pastor when I was 3. We adopted my 2 younger brothers who were 2.5 and 6 weeks when I was 4. So my life was always busy. There was never a day when I was not at church. The church was literally an everyday thing. Sundays, Tuesdays, Thursdays, Fridays, literally there every single day of the week. It was a crazy life. Went to private school, but basically it was like a public school because it's like all the rejects from public school. So lived in the, we call it the private public school. You paid to go to public school, basically, there. From kindergarten to 5th grade, I went to that school, but during my time there, I was molested by a fellow classman when I was 8. So that pretty much screwed me up from that point on. Never hanged out with the guys. Mostly hanged out with the girls. I had very few guy friends. All my friends were girls. They all would protect me and, like, basically stand up for me when I know I couldn't. So, yeah. I was a good kid other than that situation which happened. Went into homeschool starting sixth grade because the school found out about that kid that molested me and found out that he was doing some other very inappropriate things. And so they expelled him, but my parents found out as well and took me and my younger brothers out and started to homeschool us. Probably, I believe it was the best decision, but sometimes as a kid you don't see it that way. So I figured, I took it really wrong. I was like, this sucks. I'm gonna miss all my friends, even though my school was on the other side of the freeway from me. But it didn't really matter. As a kid, you really couldn't do much. From the age of 12, that's when you're basically, that's when life is changing. You're slowly turning into an adult. Not really, but you're growing up. And because of what happened to me, I thought guys liked me. But the thing was, I liked girls too. So I was like, well, I don't know what to do about this. So I was bisexual for about 4.5 years of my life. During that time, because I was homeschooled and really didn't have that many friends because I was homeschooled, I was very, very depressed. Really didn't like going to church anymore, except for the fact that my parents forced me to go. My friends at church were basically in the same boat as me. Like, everyone's growing up, everyone's depressed. So it's not like it was like fun at church anymore. And all my friends were older, so like they were growing up, going off to college, so it was just, there's not that many of us. I have attempted suicide about 7 times in my life. Specifically between those 4.5 years, from 12 to about 15-ish. Pastor Chuck Smith, he's the guy who started the Calvary Chapel movement, also started the Bible College, on which me and Nate and a lot of our friends go to, which is this beautiful place that I'm sitting at. Pastor Chuck Smith gave my aunt Patty a flyer for this youth camp called On the Edge, and he was like, hey, I heard you have a nephew around this age, you should send him to it. And she was like, okay. She gave it to my parents. I was like, nah, I really don't want to go to that, it sounds boring. I really didn't want to go to some Christian little retreat. I didn't even know what a retreat was to begin with. Went to a small church, so we didn't have those kind of things. And I was like, I don't want to go. So, that happened when I was 13, 14-ish. Well, actually, that whole entire 13-year age, I dated a dude, which is not something like I'm like proud of, but I did. Fortunately, he got my first kiss, which sucks, but that's okay. The Lord forgives. 2014 rolls around, we went to retreat, my mom and dad were like, hey, you're going, and I was like, what? They told me the day before, so I had to pack that night. Went, and I was like, I liked it because of the fact that I had freedom, because my parents are extremely strict, and like, you wasn't allowed out the front door to go get the mail, how strict my parents were. But I was like, oh, I like this because of the freedom. I really didn't care about Jesus. I was like, not really. I didn't really care about the Lord because of the fact of what happened to me when I was 8. I was like, I blamed him for that. I was mad at him for allowing it to happen to me. I was like, my dad's a pastor and you're going to let this happen to me? Like, what the heck? I thought you cared about your children. And I was like, look at that. But, yeah. Went to they had a summer retreat too, which was for 5 weeks during the summer. You would stay here on this campus, basically going through Bible College boot camp. I enjoyed it because of the fact I earned some lifelong friends from that retreat. I also got experience freedom for 5 weeks and not having to have my parents over my shoulder 24/7. And I was like, oh, I love this. I love this. I'm going to go again. 2015 comes around. My ex dumped me because of the fact he was moving to Colorado. And he's like, I never loved you in the first place, so I just wanted you for the attention. And goodbye. He dumped me. And because of that, I tried to kill myself. Not the first time. It was like the fourth time. Each time, tried to do it by hanging because didn't have a gun. I was afraid of basically medicine. So pills were not an option because I was afraid of it. So yeah, hanging was the only way I would actually probably try to kill myself when I did. 2015, winter retreat comes. I go to this retreat and this is the first time I hear the Lord's voice. Like I just hear him like speaking to my heart, like saying like, you're gonna be mine. And I was just like, nope, that's what you think. Nope, nope. But deep down in my heart, I knew if I went to that summer edge, I was gonna get saved. Like, basically, like, I'm gonna become a Christian. You know? And I didn't want that. It was like, I'm gonna have to give up everything in my life that I want to keep. Because my dad's a pastor. I know how Christianity works. But 2015 edge, the summer comes around, and I'm like, well, I guess I have to go. Try to kill myself the night before. A very scary experience. Won't go into too much detail. Basically, I just tried to kill myself. But the Lord saved me. Long process. A lot of darkness. But the Lord brought light into my life that night. And I was like, okay, I guess I'm going to accept the Lord. But I didn't know when I was going to do it. I was low-key procrastinating on accepting Jesus at that point. I was like, yeah, you saved me from all the death, but I'm like, do I really want you right now? Basically procrastinating as much as I do in my homework. But June 29th, 4 days after my actual birthday, I gave my life over to the Lord. They had a power and purity conference, and one of the speakers had been a lesbian for so many years, and there was this stigma in the church where it's like, if you're gay or if like anything like that, you can't be saved. And that was like a belief that I had believed, because I was like, oh, it's like the ultimate sin, like there's no way of coming out of that. But she was like, look at me, I'm a Christian and I came from that lifestyle, you can be saved in the name of Jesus. And I was just like, fine, Lord, I'm done fighting you. Take me as your own. Ran forward, fell flat on my face, and yeah, I have been a Christian. This year will be my fifth year being a Christian. I'm really thankful. A lot of things have happened since then. Got saved, had great friendship. I kept going to On the Edge now as staff and like helping out with the students and stuff like that, trying to teach them about the Lord. I had gotten into a relationship with, not a girl from the retreat, but a girl from my church. It was like a really weird relationship. It was not toxic, but at the same time, it wasn't like
edifying
or beneficial in any way. It was just really just a stupid love, like really. And found out after we broke up because my dad decided to go plant a church 2017, and so we went to go plant a church, and we were leaving. I was like, well, we can't like hang out or like even talk anymore, because I didn't have a phone until I was 17, so it's not like I could actually talk to her anymore. So I was like, okay, yeah, so we're not in a relationship. Found out afterwards that she had been cheating on me the whole entire time with other dudes from the church, sleeping with them, and basically she wanted to do the same thing with me. Low-key, the Lord saved me from all that. Not low-key, high-key. He saved me from all that, and I'm super thankful, because Lord have mercy.
Been there.
17 Edge, Summer Edge, basically become best friends from my now fiance. We got into a relationship 2018, and I definitely have seen the Lord grow me through this relationship. Like, a lot of things have changed in my life, and Gabrielle has definitely, like, been that, like, mirror of the Lord towards me, like, the mirror reflecting the light, almost brighter than the moon. Like, that's what she has been for me. Like, she's been showing me how the Lord is through love, and, like, I've been, like, accepting that a lot more, and, like, fully understanding who I am in Christ, that I'm not anything that this world's trying to tell me. Nothing of this world can, like, make me feel good. Nothing can make me happy except for Christ and the things that come from Him and are of Him. And I've been realizing that more and more, especially these past few semesters of Bible college, seeing other Christians around my age being so diligent in wanting to learn about the scriptures, whether or not their parents sent them here or not, still was blessed to see everyone's heart slowly and quickly get changed by God's goodness. Basically, if I was to summarize my testimony in a sentence, I would say, out of the darkness and into the light, so was my life as it was. I was blind, but now I see. Once gay, now I'm holy. That's basically what I can say.
Amen. As you guys just saw, that was Pete. Love this guy. Him and I became really best friends last semester, because last semester was my first semester. I meant to do all of this last semester, but dragged my feet and was... But anyway, besides the point, this is just one of the many testimonies that you guys will hear, just from, like, a numerous of different people. Like, we've all come from different backgrounds. Some people didn't know the Lord at all, came here and got changed, and then so on and so forth. It just... You never know what you'll see and exactly how God will work in people's lives. So let me get my big bald head out of the bright light so you can actually see my face. So through this, I just pray that you guys will just continue. If you haven't found the Lord and you're watching this, I just pray that you would find Him wholeheartedly, because as you saw from my friend Pete, God can change, and He does it through amazing love. He pursues us and He never forces us. And I hope you guys remember that. You guys take it easy. Welcome back, party people. It is a Wednesday night.
Hi!
So tonight is open mic night, as you can hear and you can see. Everybody's gonna get together, do some original songs,
is
you
this
know.
One of your vlogs?
Yes. And they ask and then they run, but it's okay. I'll check you guys in a second. I'll see if I can get somebody to record for me. You may and you may not get to hear me sing. We'll know.
High vlog!
Oh my gosh. You guys take it easy. Welcome back, everyone. We just left worship leadership. I know usually I do the introduction, but yeah.
What's up, yo?
This is my buddy Lloyd.
Hello. Como estas?
Wait, huh? I'm just kidding. Como estas?
Yeah, como estas. How are you?
Muy bien, gracias, y tú?
That's right.
And so we just left class as usual. It's Thursday. Worship leadership was fantastic.
See you, bro.
Later's a whole lot of conviction. So I guess I don't really have a message for today. Andrew.
What's up?
What do you think the people should know from class today?
From class?
Yes.
Gospel-centered worship, man. Just focusing your song list as worship leaders. Just around the fall of man, around the redemption of Christ, around the assurance we have in Him, and around just the thanksgiving of just knowing that we're saved. And I mean, just God's so good, man. Like, seriously. Oh, you are recording me. Oh.
Yes, it's for the vlog.
Shoot.
I guess I caught him off guard. And that's our buddy Ann called from in the background. But anyway, guys, remember. Remember, guys. I can't get it out. Remember to like, comment, subscribe. Don't forget that Jesus loves you. And I guess that's it. This vlog was pretty weird, but hey, I hope you guys still got something out of it as Peach shared his testimony, as I almost got ran over, as well as what John and Jeff spoke from Ags the other day. Just continue to keep seeking the Lord. And if you have not found Him yet, or you do not know Him, I pray that through this, or by some divine way, somebody comes along and shares the amazing gospel with you, that you do find Christ. Love you guys, and I'll see you guys in the next vlog.